let's look at this question. The coach of a basketball team picks 6 players for any tournament from out of 11 players available, A through K. Among these 11 players, there are 5 types of players: point guards, point forwards, shooting guard, small forwards and centers, such that there are exactly 3 point guards, 2 point forwards, 2 shooting guards, 2 small forwards and 2 centers. Okay, so out of the 11 players that are present, 3 are point guards, 2 are point forwards, 2 are shooting guards, 2 small forwards, 2 centers. Okay, the coach picks the 6 players such that any team contains exactly 2 point guards, 1 point forward, 1 shooting guard, 1 small forward and 1 center. The coach picked the following teams for different tournaments. Okay, when you look at these 4 teams, the things that should be your trigger are: point guards come maximum number of time, centers in the 4 teams, there will be 4 centers mentioned, but number of point guards in the 4 teams, there will be 8 point guards mentioned. Similarly, point forwards would be 4, shooting guards would be 4, small forwards would be 4, but point guards would be mentioned 8 times for 4 teams, 2 point guards per team, there would be 8 point guards. So the first step that I do is I will list down how many times a player has come in the team, so that I am able to better gauge which person has come maximum number of times. He will be the most likely candidate for point guard. Let's work. A is coming 2 times, B is coming 2 times in team 1 and 4, C is coming 2 times in team 2 and team 4, A, B, C, D. D is coming team 1 and team 3, 2 times, E is coming in 2, 3 and 4, so he is coming 3 times, yes, E is coming more number of times than A, B, C, D, that is wonderful. E, F, let's look at F, team 2 and 3, 2 times, E, F. G, let's look at G, 1, 2 and 4, so he is also coming 3 times, okay, 3 times, I should be paying attention to G, E, F, G, let's look at H, H is coming 2 times in 1 and 3, I is coming 3 times in 1 and 3, sorry, 1, 2 and 3, so he is also coming 3 times, I should also pay extra attention to I, then let's look at J, he comes 2 times, and then let's look at K, he comes once. Okay, so E, G and I come 3 times and K comes once. Our first attention should always be to the extremes. Let's look at E, who has come 3 times. Who all has he teamed up with? E has teamed up with A in team 2, with B in team 4, with C in team 2, with D in team 3. E is of course with E, then you have F in team 3, then you have G in team 4, G, then H in team 3, then I in team 3, then J in team 3 and K in team 4. So there are 10 people with whom E has teamed up. Now see, the only sort of players with whom everybody can team up is a point guard. Because if you are a point forward, the other point forward can never be in the team. If you are a shooting guard, the other shooting guard can never be in the team. If E is teaming up with all the 10 players, can I conclude that point guard wise, E is definitely there. E is definitely a point guard. And as soon as you identify E is a point guard, cancel out E from all these recordings. E is no longer valid for our consideration. E is definitely a point guard. Okay, let's do the same processing for G. G can team up with A, with B, with C, with D, of course with E, with F, G is there with G, H, I, J and K. For G also, can you see he is able to team up with all 10 players? So similar conclusion is E, if G is able to team up with all the 10 players, G is also a point guard. We have, out of the 3 point guards, we have identified 2. Wonderful. Let's also mark out G everywhere. Now see, in every team there were supposed to be 2 point guards. For team 2 and team 4, we know who the 2 point guards are. But for team 1 and team 3, there is supposed to be one other person who is supposed to be a point guard. and that person has to be common. Let's see, common players in team 1 and team 3 are D, H and I. Common players in team 1 and team 3 are D, H and I. Out of these three players, sadly, I cannot be a point guard. Because look at team 2, E and G, two point guards are already there. I is also here. It means I cannot be the third point guard. So he is out of the running. The third point guard I know has to be necessarily D or H. The third point guard has to be D or H. I don't know which. Maybe later we get a unique case. But as of now, the third point guard has to be D or H. Okay. Then let's go to I and look at who all he can team up with. I can team up with A, B, C, D, then E, then I'm looking at I, so F is also there, G is of course there, H, I and H, yes, H, and then J. Okay, I know I is not a point guard, I is a separate group. Which group? I don't know. I is a separate group. Okay. Now, when I is a separate group, I can come with A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, J. The only person with whom I is not making a grouping, is not appearing in the team. See, A is coming, B is coming, C is coming, D is coming, E is coming, F is coming, G is coming, H is coming, I itself is there, J is coming. I is definite, is not teaming up anywhere, only with K. And therefore, I and K have to come from the same group. Which group? I don't know. It could be shooting guard or center or point forward or small forward. I don't know which group. But I and K will definitely be in a group. So now when we know I and K are definitely in the group, let's also remove I and K from the running everywhere. Okay. Now, let's work forward. K is known, so I don't need to care for K anymore. I know K is pairing up with I. Let's go to A now and see who all he's teaming up with. He's teaming up with B, C, D, E, F, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. E and G are wonderful. They are with everyone. Is A teaming up with H? Yes, H. Is A teaming up with I? Yes, he used to team up with I, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. Is A teaming up with J? No, he's not teaming up with J. He's not teaming up with K. Apart from A, there are supposed to be 10 people, out of which 8 are mentioned. The two people that A does not team up with are J and K. Now, K is already in a group with I. So, the only person A can be in cahoots with is J. So there is another group A and J that is identified. Okay, A and J is also identified now. Let's do the same processing for B. A, is B and C coming together somewhere? Yes, C. Is D and B coming together somewhere? Yes, for team 1, D. E is of course coming. F and B. F and B are not teaming up anywhere, right? F is here and F is here. B is here and B is here. So F is not here. So one possibility will be F. Then G will be here. H and B are teaming up. H and B are teaming up. I. Is I teaming up with B somewhere? Yes, in the first team itself. I is teaming up with B. G-H-I-J. Is J teaming up with B? Yes. J is teaming up with B and also K. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So you know 9 people B is teaming up with. The only person he's not teaming up with is F. So B and F will make a pair. Okay. Wonderful. Now let me just check the... We have assigned A, we have assigned B, we have not assigned C, we have not assigned D, we have assigned E, we have assigned F, we have assigned G, we have not assigned H, we have assigned I, we have assigned J, and we have assigned K. In group wise, we have assigned. So C, let's see, can C make a group with D? Has C ever appeared with D? No, C has never appeared with D. So you can have a possibility of CD. Has C ever appeared with H? C has come in two times and he has not appeared with H. So the only people that C has not appeared with are D and H. The only people that C has not appeared with are D and H. And therefore, the fifth group will be either C and D and H. It should also fill your heart with confidence that this arrangement or this setup that we are working with is correct. Because look at PG, you had the possibility D or H here. And for with C, you have the possibility D or H here. So now we know the five groupings that are available. Now for these four that are here, they could be shooting forward. They could be point forward. They could be shooting guard or they could be center. I don't know who is what, but these four groupings here and one grouping here, this is known. First question, who among the following is a point guard? Option B is definitely a point guard. Which of the following players are definitely of the same type? Which of the following players are definitely of the same type? Look at option one, A and J. That is correct. If B is a shooting guard, okay, so now this becomes shooting guard and H is a small forward. If H is a small forward, then D is a point guard. Okay, this is a shooting guard. This is a, sorry. B is a shooting guard. H is a small forward. So this is small forward. Okay, who among the following is a center? Is a center. Okay. Now see, C will be a small forward, E will be a point guard, F will be a shooting guard. So among the following is a center, D none of the above. Had it been I, K, A or J, it would still have been slightly more convoluted, but not possible. Also make sure you remove these points for the subsequent processing because this was only valid for question number 3. If one of the two centers was picked in 3 of the 4 teams, if one of the two centers was picked in 3 of the 4 teams. Now, the only person who was picked in 3 teams but was not a point guard. So, this is the center grouping. IK is the center grouping. Who among the following is a center? E, not a center. A, not a center. B, not a center. Center will necessarily be K. The inherent or the underlying logic used here is look at the extreme cases, the things that are present in abundance. They will give you the way forward as to which groupings would work here. A wonderful question, extremely logical.